Today we're going to talk about using thermal profiling in soldering operations. As boards go through solder reflow or wave solder, every area of the board has to reach the right temperature for soldering and remain there for the right amount of time. You can't heat the board too quickly, or you can get splatter and solder balls. You can't heat it too slowly, or the flux can dry out before a good solder joint forms. Overheating damages components, and insufficient heating gives you bad solder joints. A printed circuit board's thermal profile shows its temperature over time during soldering. It's affected by the number of layers. More layers means more copper and a greater amount of heat absorbed. And different sections of the same board can have different profiles. Areas like this with lots of copper heat up more slowly than areas like this. You can optimize solder machine settings to get the profile right for each board. To do this at Z-axis, we use a data pack, data acquisition hardware, in a heat shield case. Temperature probes from the data pack are attached in several places to the board to be profiled. Where there will be larger, heavier components, we add an appropriate mass to mimic the local impact on heating. The data pack goes through the solder machine with the bare board, recording board temperatures the entire time. When removed, it gives us time versus temperature graphs for different areas of the board. We analyze these graphs to ensure that no area of the board exceeded the maximum temperature ratings for the components, that we didn't exceed the maximum rate of heating, that all areas of the board reached the right temperature and held it for the right amount of time for preheating and for reflow, as specified by the solder data sheet. If we need to, we can change the rate of heating by independently adjusting several different temperature zones in the solder machines. When we get the profile right, we store the settings by board part number in the memory of the solder oven or wave solder machine. Then, for each production run, we can enter that board's part number and automatically pull up the settings to optimize soldering for that board. Not a lot of high-mix manufacturers do this. Most simply create 3 or 4 standard profiles based mainly on board density and run all of their jobs using one of these close enough standard settings. But by measuring, optimizing, and recording the unique thermal profile of each board designed during pre-production, at Z-axis we achieve lower solder defect rates in manufacturing. It's another way that we improve quality while reducing costs for our customers.